But first, winter time is no time to hibernate. Instead, get winter active.
Well, it's really important to stay active year-round, and especially during the winter when some people get a case of the winter blues, then being physically active is a great way to reduce your stress levels, keep your energy up, and improve your circulation, which is important if you want to stay warm during the winter months. I think that people convince themselves that staying inside and keeping warm is the best way to stay healthy during the winter, but actually the opposite is true, and people need to still get outside and enjoy being active. If you're prepared, if you have the right clothing, the right footwear, the right attitude, and you make the right accommodations to activities so that they're right for the conditions, then you'll be ready to be winter active. Well, it's important to be practical, not fashionable, when you're dressing for the winter weather. So first of all, you want to think about dressing in layers. So having multiple lightweight layers that you can remove once you've been active for a while, you've worked up a bit of a sweat, will be helpful. It's also really important to stay dry. So you want to make sure that your outer layers are at least water resistant, so that if you have a lot of snow or you're rolling in the snow, that you're going to be able to stay dry and warm underneath. Gloves and toque are necessary, a scarf as well, to keep your neck warm. If you're nice and bundled and warm, you're likely to stay outside longer and be active for longer. It's very important to have sturdy boots that are preferably waterproof, that have insulation in them, and a thick rubber sole that has good grips so that you can stay on your feet in the snow and ice. It's important for families to be active together, so for parents to be role models and be active themselves, not just send children outside to play, but for adults to bundle up and get outside themselves. If you're an older adult, then we would recommend that you be cautious about the areas that you choose to walk in. Choose a well-lit area, some footwear that has good grips, or you may want to consider using a device such as yak tracks that attach to the bottom of your shoes and give a little bit of extra grip on the snow and ice. And if you're a little nervous about being outdoors or the weather's just too cold, then you can consider checking out your local mall for mall walking times, or you can consider taking an AquaFit class, walking on a treadmill, or perhaps just getting a gentle exercise video to put in your machine at home. In certain winter sports or activities, it's important to be head smart, and that means wearing a helmet. So if you're going to be going out skiing, or you're going to be tobogganing even, especially with small children, it's important to have a helmet and prevent head injuries. Wear something reflective on your clothing so that you can be seen. You want to make sure that you have plenty of water before and after your activity. And if you're going to be out for a long time, you want to take some water with you. Sun safety is another important issue in the winter. Many people think that it's not as hot or it's not as sunny, so I don't need to be concerned. But we still recommend that you do wear sunscreen with an SPF of 15. And sunglasses are also important. With the bright white snow on the ground, it can be hard on your eyes if you're not wearing proper sunglasses. The benefit of being outside and active in the winter is that you don't have to contend with the heat of summer. So sometimes it can be easier to be active for longer periods of time. You don't have the bugs to contend with either, so that can be a positive. Well, the snow is fun, it's free, and if you're prepared, it can be fabulous.